In the wake of Trump's announcement to review laws pertaining to transgender rights, people from and in support of the LGBT community have stepped up to express their concerns, including here in Dubuque.
Including the trans population.
Indigo Channing stands in Washington Park, portraying a simple message.
Trans people exist.
Just last week, President Trump announced that his administration is taking a look at whether or not a person's sex should be biologically defined at birth.
Taking a stance that, you know, this is determined at birth and this is it, what we're doing is we're taking the ability for people to have life-saving treatments covered by insurance.
In the USA, there are 700,000 people that identify as transgender. Of the 50 states, there are 18 with clear protection laws. The other 32 have either partial protection or none at all. It is because of this that people like Indigo and students like Whitney are taking the time to advocate for transgender rights.
It just makes a lot of people really nervous for their own rights and their own safety every day.
If President Trump decides to pursue his intended action, those who undergo transgender surgery or simply choose to identify as the other sex will have no federal protection to do so. The new law would require everyone born in the U.S. to follow their assigned sex at birth.
I'm comfortable with who I am and I'm happy the way I am, and I feel like everyone deserves that chance.
It's this idea of self-identification that motivated speaker after speaker to share their message of hope.
We have to look at the long term, like what can we do to help heal ourselves and to heal the society.
Now, President Trump's talk of changing laws pertaining to transgender people is at a standstill, with some party members pushing back against this idea.